Over the past few days, we've seen quite a bit in the way of Fallout 76 news. It seems like one of the major trends we've been seeing is around glitches or hacks, exploits, things like that in Fallout 76 post-Wastelanders. Several problems with the DLC may have popped up. That's actually a part of the discussion. It seems like some of these may be fake problems, other ones very genuine. But even further, we have some general news around the future of this game, where it might be heading next or where it isn't heading next. But with that said, if you guys enjoy the content, I do encourage you to leave a favorite and 5-star rating. But otherwise, let's first take a look about where this game is and isn't heading next. Just recently, Pete Hines was on the Fallout Hub podcast. Actually, I was also on this episode of the Fallout Hub podcast. I have a link to this down below if you guys do want to check it out. It is a pretty cool listen. But some of the notable things that were mentioned during this were actually by Pete Hines around the future of Fallout 76 on a high level. He reiterates how Wastelanders is really acting as a new base to build off of. Going to Wastelanders, I had this idea that it didn't even have to be that good. It had to be good enough to actually sell the game again, and it definitely did deliver on that front. But even further, with Wastelanders and all the new systems it adds in, that single-player-esque functionality, it gives Bethesda a nice platform to build up future story DLC experiences. And as a result of that, when the next big story DLC comes out, I imagine there's going to be a lot of interest. Although, it doesn't seem like Bethesda is just going for story DLCs in the future. Pete Hines describes how some of the future updates are going to be more focused on player desires, so it's not just going to be a bunch of story DLCs back to back, but rather they're going to be going in several directions. Seemingly, there will be story DLCs, but also other aspects of the game, including some of the social features, will get expanded. One thing he does mention here are things like base building. Hopefully there'll be some new content or updates around that functionality and the tools there are. But then he also does say this.
You know, the M word is still floating out there, people wanting to know about, hey, what about mods? And you know, that's always been something that we've brought to the Fallout franchise based on the stuff we did in Elder Scrolls, and something that at some point I'd like to see us bring an answer and a solution to for folks who want to change their experience in some ways. So, but you know, the time frame I'm talking about there is not. And hey, let's see if we can pull all that off by June, right? We're talking about years, like over the next few years, how are we going to continue to grow?
I want to play that clip to you because it's not explicitly saying mods aren't coming soon, but it kind of is saying that. Seemingly, mod support is not something currently implemented or a couple of weeks or even months away. My takeaway from that clip is they have some ideas on a high level, but I wouldn't expect to see mod support for Fallout 76 anytime soon. And if anything, based off that, it doesn't even feel like it's currently in development. Which isn't surprising. I've made several videos on this topic, actually just one a couple of weeks ago that I encourage you guys to check out. It also goes over some of the most recent mod releases for 76. But overall, I think this is going to be interesting. Obviously, Wastelanders thus far has been a huge success, but it was very particular. It really returned the game to a single-player-esque experience, which I'm very happy about and many others are very happy about. And in fact, on that note, on Steam, the reviews for Fallout 76 just crossed over into mostly positive, with over 75% of the reviews being positive. That's crazy. Like, I think if you told someone that 3, 4, 5 months ago, they probably wouldn't believe you. But up next, I think it'll be interesting to see how things are received when Bethesda returns to a focus on social features. Maybe the next big story DLC isn't till November. We don't really know, that's just me speculating. But maybe for the summer months, we'll see something more like a new multiplayer mode, very similar to how things worked last year. Another big thing to remind you of is there's actually going to be an AMA tomorrow. Some of the leads on Fallout 76 will be answering questions. I'm going to be covering this, but I think it's going to be a very interesting one to pay attention to. As I mentioned in the past, Bethesda has used Q&As to announce new or future features. Right now, Fallout 76 is coming off a very positive wave of news. Giving some people something to hold on to get excited for in the future, could be a major thing they talk about here. Or it could just be answering questions about Wastelanders, so who knows. But then moving on to the next stage of this, just recently we've seen quite a bit in the way of bugs, exploits, or other things of that nature with Fallout 76. I don't know why exactly, but just over the past 3 days or so, there have been a lot of different stories of different things popping up. One of the big ones, and I talked about this in my last video, was a new dupe exploit involving display cases and the player vending machines. Those were disabled, although earlier today, Bethesda addressed this in a hotfix and they have been re-enabled. So that's definitely good, and it's cool to see Bethesda continues to do these hotfixes with no downtime. One of the first ones, and this seems like a very real and genuine problem, although Bethesda is aware of it, is while doing some quest events or just fighting against NPCs, there is a bug where you could basically die, somehow drop your weapon, and then the NPC steals it. And with the way Fallout 76 works, you can't just loot it off their body, you have effectively lost that weapon. And it seems like the ammo for it also. That sounds very fake. Fallout 76 in general has a lot of fake stories like this, but there actually is some video evidence of this, and I know of a couple of people that have been impacted by this one. It seems like some of the factors that are involved is, one, you have to die, so if you don't want to lose your weapon, just don't die. Or things like goo piles, or the other piles of mass that you get after taking down an enemy. So when the body transitions into not being a body anymore. It seems to be very circumstantial, it's not totally clear if those are just the two characteristics, but either way, again, this seems like it is a very real problem. People are actually losing stuff from this. In a similar vein, another video that popped up is around a power armor deletion bug, where basically after placing down power armor, getting into it, some kind of bug, glitch, something happens, and the power armor pieces on that frame are lost. This isn't quite as bad as you can create power armor. Legendary weapons are random rolls and sometimes very hard to get. There's another one where it's not really clear what's happening. We have this video and several other people have said they've had similar things happen to them. Another one Bethesda is investigating. Another curious one that isn't quite as bad is seemingly somebody found an explosive Gatling plasma, this being post-Wastelanders based off the quests that are on screen. In the video, you could see someone take down a legendary enemy, and as they go to loot the body, they find a explosive Gatling plasma, which hypothetically shouldn't be able to drop. Explosive energy weapons used to be a feature of the game, but Bethesda removed them quite a while ago. They still exist, but they are legacy, so this seemingly being a new one would be odd and not intentional. This video could have been faked. There's actually a number of ways they could have faked it, but again, this isn't quite as consequential, just more of an interesting one that has popped up. So all of those have video footage to back it up and do seem very real or plausible. Seems like on each of those cases, Bethesda has been made aware of it thus far. And one of the big questions we'll see going forward is, will people get their items back? In the past, Bethesda support has been pretty iffy about this. The most well-known example being of the user who lost an entire inventory doing the vault raids, managed to get it captured on footage when it happened again, and initially Bethesda support was not being helpful or not actually doing anything. Over time, I don't know what happened, a couple of weeks after the fact, they did end up restoring his character, but you oftentimes will hear the line from Bethesda support that they don't have the tools to do it. Although seemingly they do in fact have the tools to do it because they've done it. Maybe now post-Wastelanders, things will be different, things will be better, but I would just be wary. Your best bet is to actually get footage if you experience one of these bugs or glitches. Obviously, that's kind of hard if you don't have a way to record the past 30 seconds or so, but if you do, definitely capture that. But on the other side of things, we do have several bugs or exploits that aren't really verifiable. There have been several claims about people getting hacked. There isn't really any evidence of this, just several independent claims of people getting hacked. One of the theories as to how this worked was that basically people would be able to connect somebody else's Bethesda.net account to their Steam account and then get a free Steam copy on that account and then in turn actually access that player's inventory. But this one, it's really hard to verify. I haven't seen much proof one way or the other. Bethesda is also seemingly investigating this one. And I honestly don't have much to tell you other than people don't really know now, just a lot of back and forth and arguing. Very similar to this, we also do have the stash steal exploit, which we talked about last week, where seemingly using player vending machines, there was a way to actually get items and buy them from somebody's stash, even if it wasn't for sale. It seems like there may have been a way to do this, but it was very specific on very specific types of servers that have lag or some other characteristics. That's another one where there's just a bunch of back and forth. There hasn't been any proof brought forward, and several people have tried to recreate this unsuccessfully. These being people who in the past have successfully recreated other exploits to report to Bethesda. And just overall, when it comes to some of this stuff, there definitely are some suspicious things going on, some glitches or problems in the game, but in the past there have been times where people just made things up. Hacks going around that just got carried by word of mouth, but apparently were never real. So without any actual proof, I would be wary about some of these things. But again, for everything I've talked about, it seems like Bethesda is aware of it, so hopefully we'll see some fixes or responses to these problems. Although a couple of things that also have popped up that aren't quite as bad or harmful for the game. There is a faction reputation exploit, so you can max out your reputation with one of the factions, but you have to be at a certain point in the questline with them. It's getting pretty popular now, a lot of people do know about it, and it'll be interesting to see how Bethesda responds to this. Faction reputation, it's something that typically takes a good amount of time to grind, either a couple of weeks or 48 hours or so grinding random encounters. Will they reset people's faction reputation in response to this? Is that even something they can do? We're kind of in unprecedented ground here, so it'll be curious to see what happens. Also, another big market to just pop out are eBay sellers selling some of the new items with Fallout 76. When you get into that final grind, you'll quickly realize that the gold bullion system takes a while to totally get through. It'll be weeks of grinding and doing events as well as other things to get enough gold bullions. With one of the big factors being you actually can't trade any of the things you unlock via this system. So if you get some cool new plans for a cool new armor, you can't sell that to somebody else, it's just for you. But it seems like, based off some of the older hacks that are out there, some people are one, unlocking some of these new items, but then two, are using some of those legacy hacks to actually now transfer those items. And these are going for astronomical price, hundreds upon hundreds of dollars, which is kind of crazy. One of the other things to pop up as of late is actually the new Communist bundle. This being long anticipated, the power armor looking just really cool. A few things we can infer from this. It looks like Bethesda actually lowered the price of power armor skins. In the past, basically all of the mainstream power armor skins to come out were 1800 points. But now, with the past two, the responders and this one, it's been lowered to 1400, that being roughly a $4 discount. There's been a long-term back and forth between the community and people running the Atomic Shop, I guess, where the community argues if things were cheaper, I would buy them more often, but Bethesda continuously has fairly high prices. But it definitely seems like we're seeing a change with this. Likely Bethesda has somebody managing this and they realize that you'll get more sales at this lower price and in turn higher revenue overall. Although something else that has popped up as a mini but also not real controversy is this new Communist Collectron. The Collectrons in Fallout 76 are basically an item you could place down and it will collect things from the area. With several of the new ones that have been data mined and now released with this one, they actually collect different things. The vanilla one just collects junk, but this one actually will now collect food, water, grenade, and some bad weapons. So now, of course, having a thing that will just produce food for you for free over time but cost real-world dollars is potentially pay to win. But when it comes to this one, it really isn't a problem. It takes so long to actually produce food items that your natural hunger and thirst will decay faster than this thing could keep up. So if you're just relying on this Collectron, it wouldn't be able to feed you sufficiently. Although another one that will be interesting that is seemingly on the horizon is the Raider Collectron. This has been data mined for a while now, and this is one that will collect chem items. And to be fair, between the Raider Collectron as well as this new Communist one, I would say they're probably the two best offers out of the bunch. Even though it's not much food, it's still handy to have some free food every once in a while. But again, it's at such a slow rate that I don't honestly think it's much of a problem. I'm not a fan of this type of content getting added in general, but this one isn't giving you some huge advantage that the other $5 one that just collects junk isn't. Something else pretty interesting around Wastelanders is the continued interest in the DLC. The Steam player count for Fallout 76, which of course isn't totally representative, has actually kind of maintained solid numbers. It of course peaked out over this past weekend, but the numbers from later last week still match the numbers they're hitting today, and yesterday and the day before that. It's not like there was a massive player drop off after that first week, people just giving it a try and then moving on, which actually wouldn't have been shocking, especially with how many people got a free Steam copy just because they owned it in the past. It seems like people are genuinely sticking with the game at least now as we enter into the second week. Even further, we just saw it break into the top 20 games on Xbox. I think it'll be really interesting to track these numbers over the long term. On Steam right now, it still is actually under Fallout 4 in general, but only slightly. But Wastelander's main story is relatively short. Not too short, I don't think it's a fault, but you can play through it pretty quickly. I know a lot of people, especially returning players, are focusing more on some of the legacy content, the stuff that's been there from the beginning, because maybe they'd never experienced it, or maybe they're experiencing some of the changes that came to it. But as people start to beat the main story, get into that endgame grind, will they stick with the game? We know Fastnacht is a few weeks away now, so that kind of stuff could get them interested. And one final thing, if you guys didn't see, just recently I posted a video on some of the mysteries that came to Fallout 76 with Wastelanders. New things added to the game with this update that are just curious. Well, in fact, one of them was these guidestones. I encourage you to check out the full video to get the full story and lore on them. But it seems like if you connect each of these guidestones together, it actually forms some kind of map or something. It's not like they're just random designs, but they actually do go together. So I don't know what this is. I don't know if this will actually lead to a deeper mystery or if it's just something cool Bethesda did, but I kind of wanted to shout it out. I'll have links to this in the description down below to get all of your top minds on the case. Either way, though, that's pretty much going to wrap it up for this one. Hopefully you guys found this video informative. Again, we should have a ton of news tomorrow with both the AMA, but also the Inside the Vault article. But until next time, I thank you again, and I hope to see you all later.